Hey everybody, welcome to another tutorial for Metareal Stage. Today we'll be talking about labels. Labels are basically the feature that you want to use if you want to add media like images, videos, web pages to your tours. And to demonstrate that, we're at the Eco Center webpage. So the Eco Center is the recycling center of the city of Magog in Quebec, Canada. It's a very interesting place. I would recommend checking out this website, and I'll add the link to the description. But for the purposes of this video, we want to focus on this virtual tour they have on their page. So I'm gonna click play here to load our tour. And now I'm gonna click OK. And now our tour has started. Let me just make this full screen so everyone can see it more clearly. Okay, so this is a Metareal virtual tour. We can look around like this. We can jump to different panoramas like this. And go back. And you may have noticed that we have this big green play button over here. So if I click it, it's gonna load this video over here. And if I hit play over here, it's gonna play a short introduction video of the Eco Center. And I can adjust the volume like this. I can make it full screen or not full screen. And I can change other settings as you would commonly find in other video players. So this video was added to this tour using labels. Another use of labels that we have in this tour are these drone spots over here. So if I click one of them, I'm gonna jump to that spot in the sky. These are just panoramas as usual, so if I click on the ground, I'm gonna transition back to the ground. The main reason I think that the tour makers decided to add drone shots instead is because if you notice, let's get closer to a pano dot. So yeah, our pano dots are white, nearly transparent, so they will be practically invisible in the sky. This makes it much clearer that this is actually a drone shot, and it also changes the movement. So now when we click this, we're teleported instead of having to zoom into the sky, which the tour maker seems to have preferred for this shot. But we can also transition like that if we want. So really, it's a preference. So that's how labels were used in this tour. There are several other uses which we'll talk about as we go through this tutorial, but this gives you a pretty good idea of what you can expect from this feature. So now let's close this and let me show you where you can add labels to your tours. So I have this exact same tour copied to my account over here. And in order to add labels, we need to go to our tour editor. So we'll click edit tour. Then we'll switch to design view. And you'll find our labels tool over here on the left. Now, labels are only available for paid plans. So if you are in a free creator plan, you might not be able to click this or access it. Now, the first thing you'll see after clicking on the labels tool is this label management pane over here. This basically lists all of the labels that you currently have in our tour. So these are all of the videos that we have. These are all of the drone shots that we have. And you can also filter this. So for example, I want this one, so I can type 41.87 and it's gonna narrow it down to this. One warning about this though is if your label does not have any text, then you can't really use this filter. And this is also case sensitive. So if I type rotation, it's not going to show any of the drone shots, but if I type rotation in lowercase, then it's going to show all of them. So just be careful about that. And if we want to jump to any of these labels, then we can just click on it. And we will jump to that part of the tour. And if we click on this label, then it's going to load the contents of that label. Yep, so that's how to find labels that you've already made. But if you want to make a new label, then you'll have to click on the labels tool and select the point where you want to add it. So let's say we want to add a new label on this bin. So we'll click that and you'll see this white dot has appeared, and that's our new label. If you don't like where it's been placed, you can click on it and move it around and it will change the position. It will line up with the surface. So if you put it on the ground, it's gonna stick to the ground. If you put it on a vertical surface, it's gonna stick to that vertical surface. Okay, and if you want to delete this table, you just make sure it's selected and then you hit delete on your keyboard and that label will be gone. Okay, so again, let us add a label over here. So I'll click this and you see that our context pane has changed. Now it says draw label. If you want to go back to the list of labels, you can just click on this icon over here and it will take you back to the label management. And now you can see this is our new label, label 11 of 11. So going back into drawing this label. So let's go through this pane section by section, starting with types. So we have three main label types. We have desktop or mobile label, VR label, and then we have URL label. So desktop or mobile label is what you would use if you're expecting your tours to be viewed on desktop or mobile devices for the most part. VR label is what you would want to use if you're expecting your tours to be viewed on VR headsets like the Oculus, Valve Index, and so on. And URL label is very similar to desktop or mobile labels, but it has some extra features that we'll talk about in a bit. Okay, so let me just switch back to desktop or mobile label because that will probably be what you want to use for the most part. Okay, so moving down into the content section. So first we have the text box over here. So if I click this and I type, let's say hello, then I click outside of it, it's gonna load this hello text box next to my label. So that's pretty good if you want just a simple text box, but you can also change this dramatically if you just click the pencil icon over here next to text. Now you'll see our label text editor. And this will let you change the format of your text. For example, you can make this a header. And that would change the size. You can also change the size automatically like this. So just your usual text editor stuff. What's even more interesting though is you can add different media to your labels using this text editor. First of all, you can add tables like this. You can also do things like add emojis, like that. You can also add images. So you can decide to upload if you like. So let's say I want this logo to show up in my label. I can change the aspect ratio if I want. Also, if you already have it in your server or hosted somewhere, you can just copy paste the URL over here and it will load your image into your label. For videos, I just have to click this button over here. And in this case, you can't upload videos to Metareal because videos are pretty heavy files. But you can upload them anywhere else like YouTube, Vimeo, or if you have your own server, you can upload to that and just copy paste the URL over here. So I have this video from YouTube. I'm just gonna copy paste that URL. And I can change the aspect ratio over here if I want, but I'm not really interested in that. If you have an iframe code, you can also copy paste it here and some advanced settings if you want. See. Okay, so I'll hit save. And now you see we have this video embedded into our label. You can also, of course, add a link. So I'll just paste the same thing and maybe make this girl from Panima. And I can change where it opens. So let's make it open in a new window. So as you can see, lots of choices for your labels. And one last very interesting choice is if you hit this source code over here, you'll be able to see the source code of your label. So this will allow you to insert pretty much anything you like, as long as it's in HTML. You can even insert an entire web page. So for example, let's go back to our project dashboard over here. And I've published this tour already, so I can share it. And you see I have this embed code that will allow me to embed this tour to any web page, and it will look something like this. Yep, so similar to what we saw in the Eco Center website. So I'm gonna copy this and paste it into our source code and hit save. And what that does is now I have my tour embedded inside of another tour. And this can be any website you want. Like, I can embed the Metareal homepage, Metareal pricing page. You can embed a product page, maybe, whatever you want. So just a few more notes for the label text editor. You can switch between light or dark mode if you like over here. And you can also add a code block by hitting code sample over here and add special characters if you want. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with this one, so I'll just hit save. Now, one final important note for the text editor is this is only available to desktop or mobile labels and URL labels. For VR labels, you can only use this plain text version, and as you can see, it changes it into code. We're still trying to figure out the logistics of adding media to VR labels. So yeah, just one thing to note about that. Okay, that's it for today. I think this video is long enough for now. Next time, we'll talk about the rest of these settings for our labels, so you can learn everything you need to fully customize them. Thank you for watching, and happy tour building!